All right, friends, I got to share with you something that is so fun, so good, so profound, and it just puts a smile on my face. I mean, I'm usually always smiling, but I'm really smiling today. So a few days ago, I was in the place of prayer, and one of the things I really felt the Lord has called me to do is in this season to spend a few extra hours in prayer a day, really praying for revival and awakening in America. And as I was spending that time just in my spirit, I just kept seeing eagles. And so I said, all right, Lord, you're really trying to show me something about eagles. Really excited about it, because I know when you're talking about apostolic and prophetic ministry, Lord, I understand what eagles mean. God, when you talk about America, I understand what eagles mean. And so I just kind of kept praying. And this is what the Lord laid on my heart, plain as day. You are about to start to see eagles in places that you usually don't see them. Now, there's a few different ways the Lord went with this. This is so good. The Lord said, in places that you see eagles, there will be eagles in the spirit. There'll be apostles, prophets. You'll have pastors, teachers, evangelists who are walking in that anointing. It's going to be different. It's not just a good anointing. It's just not the favor of God. But if you really go and look at the characteristics of an eagle can fly so high no other bird can get near it. An eagle is always looking at a larger perspective, a heavenly perspective. You know, Matthew 6:10, your kingdom come, your will be done on earth as it is in heaven. A heavenly perspective looking down to see the full ramification of everything. An eagle can fly up so high that it can see miles beneath it, just a better just view, a better spectacle, a better range. And so the Lord was showing me that you are going to start seeing eagles in places that you don't normally see them. Okay, first part of this I want to dive into. My wife calls me and says, oh my gosh, you are not going to believe what I just saw today. I said, tell me. She said, an eagle. In fact, I whipped my, she drives a big SUV. I whipped my old SUV around and I started chasing that eagle trying to record it. Lord. Okay, then a little bit later, my mama calls me and she says, Joe, you are not going to believe what I saw today. I'm like, tell me, mama. She said, I saw two eagles. Now, in the geographical location they were at, it's about 30 miles apart. A few hours apart, pretty good chance it's not the same birds. And then I look about an hour later on social media, somebody else from our region said, oh my goodness, you're not going to believe what I saw today. I saw an eagle. Friends, I have never had anybody tell me in our region that they've seen an eagle. And then in the next few days, I see people putting all over social media, I've never seen an eagle in our region. And people have never talked about eagles in our regions, and now we're seeing them. So a few things that the Lord is showing me and saying in this right here. One, you are about to see eagles in places that you normally don't see them. You could say in anything. In a lot of churches never had an eagle type pastor. They've never let an apostle come in, a prophet come in. They see from a heavenly view. They see just the bigger spectrum of what's going on. They see it at a larger vision. And also, what do eagles do? They only deal with living things. You know, it's almost like you can kind of talk about the Nazarites into this, because the Nazarites never dealt with anything that was dead. They had to be around living things. You are also going to see in this hour that the eagle prophets, the eagle apostles, that they're not going to associate with dead ministries, dead businesses, because they are going to find what is living and they are going to insert their gift and their anointing into those. And so you're going to start seeing eagles arise. You're going to see them arise in the political arena in a very big way. I'm just letting you know, okay? Now, you're not going to see it on the mainline news, but you're going to see eagles arise in the political arena. You're going to see professional athletes. You're going to see people in Hollywood, the music industry. They're going to stand up and say, I guess the old saying, I've got a bird's eye view. But an eagle, remember, flies way above everything else. And the old dead birds, the old buzzards and stuff, they can't fly at that level. So what you got to understand, the key Eagles in this hour are going to be very strategic in who they partner with, who they do ministry with, and who they do life with. My wife and I in ministry and our health coaching business, we are looking for people just not to partner with us, but to live life with us. That's very important, very key. And a few more things that the Lord really started highlighting to me about this is in regions that you see eagles that you normally don't see them, that is also going to be an indication that God is going to raise up apostles and prophets in those regions to be eagles. You know, a lot of times when people have like a regional anointing, you know, you have like a local anointing, a regional anointing, a national anointing, a global anointing. There's going to be eagles that have local and regional anointings, and they are going to see at a greater level, and they're going to be able to speak into those regions. I know a lot of people who have regional anointings who have ministries under 100 people. And people are like, well, how can somebody with 30 people in their church give guidance and leadership? Well, maybe they spend a lot of extra time in prayer, you know? And so what you got to understand, this word is so profound. The eagles aren't just coming, the eagles are here. And you're going to start to see eagles in places that you never even thought that you would see them. And there's also some eagles that, you know, may have done great things in the past. Well, God is going to restore them, and he is going to bring them back. I also feel the Lord saying that in some places where eagles were at one time and they were pushed out, they're going to come back. There's a lot of ministers out there that almost retired. Listen, retirement's not in the Bible. If you're a minister, you still got life in you. Let's go. There's a lot of business owners who may be wealthy beyond imagination, but maybe God is calling you in this season to be an eagle to give insight to other people. Listen, now is the time for the eagles to arise. I hope this word blessed you. And like I always say, if you want prayer, go to our website, jojodawson.net. Go to the Contact Connect button. Hit it. Send me a prayer request. I would love to pray for you. I just know and believe that this is the time of the season that God is raising up eagles. And remember, a lot of times you do see eagles alone, and you're going to have to be okay with it. Somebody asked me, do you like alone time? I said I love it because it's when I really spend that time with the Lord. And, you know, I do a lot of prophetic words, you know, in different places like Elijah List and Charisma, and then also on my own blog and on social media and on YouTube a lot. And they say, where do you get your words? I say in corporate prayer, where there's just a few of us, or when I'm in my personal prayer time by myself. You know, and in that time, it's just so easy to hear the Lord. So I encourage you today, seek the Lord. Be on the lookout for eagles, because you're going to start seeing them. And also in the natural realm, you're going to see people with that strong anointing come in, and they're going to be able to speak life locally, regionally, nationally, and globally. I'm just not talking about the church world, friends. I'm talking about the business world as well. Hope you have a blessed day, and hope this video helped you.